This is an insight of the dental assistant programs. If you have any questions, just comment below. What's up, you guys? I am at my school, which is Shreveport Dental Assistant School, and I am here at the office. I'm going to show you all around, and I'm going to let you all know what all we do. I can't show you guys everything due to HIPAA, but this is where we learn everything. We did CPR in this room as well. This is our break room. Today was the last day for us, and they had us snacks, cups with goodies in it, and pizza as well. These are the rooms that we did x-rays in, moldings. We learned about the different tools to use as far as the suctions and different tools to help the doctors with how to be with the doctor, which side to be on, which hand to use, how to hand them the different instruments and things of that nature. Overall, this was a 9 weeks course, and once you paid your money in full and also went through all of the phases, you get your certificate and then you start training and or working. This room was mainly used for impressions, and that is when we use the alginate that's on the side in the containers, and we fill up the models and we place it on either the patient's teeth or the form's teeth, and we get the mold out of it. This is just the rest of the room, and they all look identical. It's our job to keep the rooms cleaned and sterilized at all times. So someone will come after me to clean up the alginate off the floor, but other than that, I'm on my way to the other room. This is the sterilizing room, and this is one of the lubricating machines. Over here is just some extra things we had to learn about. These are the steam clean machines, which are also called the autoclaves. You guys, I just called them that. That is the ultrasonic. It shakes the tools to get them clean. And this is just everything else. These are the items we use on a daily to perform any treatments. We have more, but that was just the basic tray. This is the 3D printer, I think. And here are the molds that we filled with molding powder. I'm going to take one apart to show you guys what it looks like once it's dry. This is my partner's mold. She told me that I could take it apart for her. I'm just going to brush over the little machine that's on the left-hand side of me. It helps get the bubbles out of the mold before it dries. So you just place it on there and it shakes as well. But once all the bubbles pop, then you'll take it off and then you will proceed to the other procedure that I will tell you about later on in the video. So it wasn't supposed to be that hard, but I don't know. I just didn't want to break it because it wasn't mine. And I had already taken mine apart and stuff. So I finally got it though. This is the alginate form that I was talking about. It comes as a powder and you have to mix it with water. And this is the mold. You mix this as a powder as well and you pour it into the alginate form once it's dry. And this is the bottom half, and I'm just going to take that apart and show you guys what it looks like. If you aren't careful, it will tear, like either the alginate or you will like chip your mold. And you don't want to do neither because you will have to use both of them eventually. This is a better angle for you guys, and this is the lower half. I'm basically just showing you all the results of everything. To start this process off, you have to get your molding powder, and that's on the side. And once you mix it with warm water, you pour it into your alginate form, and then you want to place it on that small machine with the plastic on it. And then once you do that, it's going to get all of the bubbles out. Once the bubbles are out, you're going to take it out, place more of the molding powder on the square plate, and you're going to put that on top of that, and you're going to let it dry. And after that, you'll have your form. This is the x-ray room. We're going to show you all how we take x-rays. Here's the tray, the gloves, the computer, and there's a numerical order that you have to take the x-rays in. So she's about to take it, so I have to step out of the room. She's going to push a button that's on the other side of the wall. I don't know if I'm going to show it, but I should, and if I don't, it's okay. Just know it's on the other side of the wall. She is getting ready to take her x-ray. She has the x-ray machine placed where she wants it. She has the sensor placed in a dummy mouth where she wants it. And she's going to take an anterior picture, which are the front teeth. And we're going to step back. She's going to push the button. And once we hear it beep, we're going to step back in the room. She's going to see which x-ray she had taken, or just to check it, just to make sure she has the right one. And there it is. It's completed. Now she's placing the sensor in the dummy's lower arch, or the mandibular arch, and she's going to take an interior photo because the teeth are in the front. And sometimes the sensor will slip out if the patient bites too hard, or it'll just slip because of the plastic. She has placed the sensor where she wants it. Now she's going to grab the x-ray machine and place it in front of the dummy's mouth or in front of the plastic ring. We have several different color rings that we use. This one has all colors on one, and you will see it on the left-hand side. But any other time, they will be like color-coded, like whole, as in all blue, all red, or all yellow, and sometimes they will come white. Now I am walking into the room that we did crowns in. The crown formula came in a tube that we had to squeeze out, and we got timed on that. And you also have to place it like on a dummy as well, and it'll get the form of a crown. And that's just a temporary before you send it into the lab. It's just a lot more steps that you have to do, but that's just the basic of it. And you know, I had to put myself in this video. I am taking an x-ray of the dummy. Sorry it looks like that. It just came from Snapchat, honestly. But yeah, had to show you guys. If this were a real patient, you would have to put a radiation jacket over them and yourself as well. So yeah, and it's pretty freaking heavy. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. Please like, share, subscribe, and tell someone. And here is a little clip of my gruesome job, but I love it though. Take care.